shit for his! Simon Cowell, shit for his! Simon Cowell, shit for his! Simon Cowell, shit for his!
But he's got a massive brain, and me and Connie Huffo think that's sexy all the same. And in 2009 he wrote a column in a paper that resonated with me just enough to read it again later. The article was all about Rage Against the Machine and a campaign to top the charts with something shouty and obscene, instead of Joe McElderry, the X Factor winner. No, I don't remember him either, but trust me, he was the winner. Now in this article that clever Charlie Boy had just written, the paragraph that made me laugh to the point of being smitten was when he said although he liked Killing in the Name, the anti-X Factor type should up their game. He said the song was just too good to get the point across, and suggested a real alternative to the X Factor dross. He said if you want to write a decent protest, my dears, you should sing a song called Simon Cowell, Shit for Ears.
Simon Cowell, shit for ears.
Down with spandex ballet, cause the point that he was making was to be more savvy and to go against the grain of all this X Factor crap and create something unlistenable and certainly not a rap. It should just be 15 seconds long and not a song at all. But we changed this idea slightly to something capable of driving every single person up the bloody wall, cause we are Spandex Ballet Jazz and this is how we roll. Besides, for this song to be eligible for charting, we needed something longer than just a recording of us farting, which suffice to say we tried at first, and funny as we found it, we felt the need to write something with a message, confound it. So we put down words and beats with Charlie's chorus intact to hopefully inspire everybody to act, cause the point is still clear, we want the world to hear Simon Cowell, shit for ears.
Simon Cowell, shit for ears.